foundation for our work is instance recognition, that is the horizontal axis in this figure, as opposed to category recognition, that is recognizing different offices as opposed to recognizing offices from cars. So instance recognition can be a tough problem, actually. This first row is images, contains images of offices in my uni, and we would have a tough time if I ask you, for example, if two of the images correspond to the same office. They all look quite similar. So this instance recognition is sometimes also quite difficult for computers for one reason, and it is the availability of data. Instance recognition sometimes, most of the times, doesn't have available data. For example, if I look in Google for images of cars and offices, I will have billions of them. But if I look for images of my office, there will be none, probably, or maybe one or two from this paper. So this is a tough question, because most machine learning algorithms fail in these situations of small data and training blind spots. So this is the aim of our research, is to propose more involved models to be able to deal with these situations. So specifically in this paper, our intention is to leverage the Manhattan structure of some scenes, for example this room, to generate synthetic views of the scene that are more or less normalized, and we extract features and classify based on these normalized views. Why we normalize the views? When you have, for example, big data and a scene, you can have almost every viewpoint from the scene of the object. But when you have small data, maybe you have only two or three views of the scene, and then it is very difficult to extract invariant features or relate the training the features from the training images here and here with the features of the test image here. So if we go to a normalized view from these two views and also use the normalized view in the test image, maybe we can extract the same invariant features in these synthetic views. So basically and specifically, what we do is to extract the vanishing points in this Manhattan scene or Manhattan image, and we divide the scene into parts, and for each part, as we have a rough estimation of the geometry of this from single view, we virtually rotate the camera, and we can synthesize a frontal parallel view of this scene, several of them, according to the geometry of the room. And from these rectified frontal parallel views, we extract the features and we do the classification. And well, we use this unsupervised mid-level patch discovery features, these features from Singh et al. But our contribution is most in this first part of rectification. So these are examples of the features we extract, and in each example, in the upper part, the first row is features extracted from standard methods, and second row is our features. So our features, it is very interesting that they tend to be extracted in stylistic details in the room and not 3D patterns. And this is good, because the 3D patterns in the room, they are the ones that change with the viewpoint. And the stylistic patterns, if you are able to get a normalized view of them, they don't change across views. So this is quite nice in these features. Of course, we have performed several baselines, so I wouldn't be here in other case. But it is very interesting that we outperform even the all-powerful deep learning. And of course, you see in the success rate in these deep features of the Places paper, it's 0.66 and ours is 0.83. The reason is, of course, that as I said, every learning technique fails in these small data assumptions, and ours is designed specifically for this small data. We also apply this to text detection. Text detection in the wild is always trained also in frontal parallel views, so they also struggle. These algorithms also struggle when they have skewed text, like in this image in the center. So we applied our algorithm to rectify the text images, and we applied the same algorithms, and they were able to detect more text. And we actually were able to improve the output of these two state-of-the-art baselines by rectifying with our algorithm the test images. And that's all. The MATLAB code is available. We also made available a data set of hotel rooms that we made to prove our claims. And if you have any questions, you can read the paper. For the details, contact the authors or visit me at the poster. Thank you.